I would entertain a motion and second to approve renewal of the city attorney and prosecutor agreement.
Second.
We have had a three-year agreement with the law firm of Farr Hickman Slavin for many years. In fact, when I did my internship here too many years ago, they were the law firm that worked with the city. And we have been renewing agreements with them. The last one was for a three-year period. It technically ended at the end of, well, sometime in January. What you have before you, the only change that is made, there are two changes. One was the change I identified for you this evening, and then there was another change regarding the renewal. If before it just said, you know, that you could make changes, but then it would expire. What we did is, if nobody has any changes, it just automatically renews. That makes sense. And so those really are the changes. It would be for another three-year period, and then at that time, you know, if there were any changes to discuss, that would happen. Then, Howard, do you have any comments?
No, that's it.
Now, did Howard read and approve this document before?
Are you biased on that?
I did have well, one of the things I didn't know, I saw with the general provisions it automatically renewing, and I completely understand that. Part of me, though, I was like, when we got this on our agenda, I was like, oh, so this is what it is. You know, I just knew Howard always sat there, but I didn't know how he got here. I didn't know what our situation was. And so I kind of liked it being renewed and me understanding that process. And so if it was renewed automatically and you have a new council member, they wouldn't, they'd be like, I was, oh, yeah, Howard just sits at the end. I mean, he's here for us. But so I just didn't know if that would be something that, it's one of those that has to renew new council members and will automatically be updated on it, where otherwise they might not.
And Carolyn, if you'd like, we could take that back and revise it in that respect. What it really said was it just terminated.
Okay.
And there was, we technically hadn't had an agreement with Howard for the last few months. So we were trying
so
to fix.
So he's working for free.
I've been gratuitously sitting.
Well, no, we've been sending checks.
He would have said something
about that. We would have got it resolved sooner. So we were trying to really address that because it just said it was over. That was it. So if you would like.
Well, I just think as long as it's brought back, maybe, you know, every 3 years, just here it is, it's automatically renewing, you see any changes, just so that, you know.
To be honest with you, the fee hasn't changed in the last number of years.
Okay.
So, and the new agreement doesn't reflect an increase in that fee either.
Okay.
So over a 6 year period, you know, I would expect maybe Howard would come back with, possibly. Probably not, though.
She's not trying to give you any ideas.
Sounded like a hint to me.
So if you're okay with that, I mean, I would expect over that next three-year period there would be possibly something that we'd want to discuss.
How did Howard, did you get to be the city attorney? Did they bid it out, or just if you were asked, or an interview process?
Actually, when I got out of law school, Harry Farr was the city attorney, and he asked that I'd be appointed assistant city attorney to help him at the time. And for a number of years, that actually not too long after that, then he stepped down and I was appointed as a city attorney. I've just been appointed on an ongoing basis from time to time. Vicki knows more about kind of some occasions when I've had to do some sort of oath or something for appointment. It's been a long time. But
the wording of change talks about 60 days prior to. So if either party gives notice 60 days prior to the end of the three-year period, is that how it's read? If you want to change something or end something or
yes.
Do something different,
yes.
At the end of the three-year, 60 days.
60 days before the end of that agreement. If Howard wanted to change, let's say the fee,
right.
He would give us notice as 60 days before.
Okay.
That we could negotiate that and then bring it to you all before it would terminate.
Prior to the change, but not necessarily prior to the end of the three-year agreement.
That's not sure.
It says, unless written notice to change, revise, or terminate the agreement is served by either party at least 60 days prior to the effective date of
mm-hmm.
any change.
You're right, Todd. You were correct.
So it could be at any time.
Could be at any time is how I read that. It's as long as you give 60 days. Tomorrow I want to make a change.
Mm-hmm. No, it's a three-year agreement. Shall automatically renew unless they've given us notice to change it before that 3 years is up.
Right.
But changes can be made any time with 60 days notice. Of any kind, like, but increase in, or whatever, decrease.
Right, Howard?
Well, Mary authored this passage. If your intent is to make it that it automatically renews unless either party gives the other party notice 60 days in advance of the end of the current term of the agreement, then I would suggest that you strike the unless written notice to, and I would strike change and revise in the word or, and so that it would read unless written notice to terminate the agreement is served by either party to this agreement by the other party at least 60 days prior to the effective date of any, and I would put it such termination, or any termination. I think it's a little bit less.
Instead of the
confusing.
Change and revision.
Yeah. Now, as a practical matter, like any contract, the parties in midstream, if they mutually agreed to modify or change the contract, they could do that. But no one party could unilaterally change.
So we've pretty much just taken out change, revise, or from those two spots, so.
Correct.
So do we want to bring it back next week, or do we just want to have it in
there? It is up to you all. If you're comfortable making that change, you can make a motion approving the amendment, and then vote on the amendment, and then vote on the agreement.
I'm fine with amending it.
Are you making a motion to amend?
I move that we amend section 4, the third line, to strike change, revise, or, and also then in the fifth line to strike change, revision, or.
Is there a second?
Second.
Any seconded? Any discussion on the change? Any discussion on the change? All those in favor of the amendment? All those in favor of the amendment, please say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Okay, amendment passes. Now I would entertain a motion to approve this agreement as amended.
So moved.
Second.
Okay. Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion carries. I think I navigated that pretty well.
Very nice. Very nice. You've learned well over this tutelage.
Thank you, Martha. All right, now I would attend a motion to approve an amendment to the agreement with GBA for Basin C&F collection system.
So moved.